This illustration illustrates about a body falling into sun from a large distance. Here we are given that a body starts from rest towards sun from a distance equal to the radius of Earth's orbit around sun. And we are required to find the time after which it will fall into sun. We are required to neglect the dimensions of sun in heliocentric reference frame with respect to sun, the reference frame we are using. And say if this is sun, and a body is located at a distance equal to the radius of Earth's orbit. Now, if it starts falling, it will be approaching sun in a straight line. But here we can use the concept of degenerated ellipse, in which we can consider if sun is at rest and a body is revolving around it in an elliptical path. Then in this situation, if a body is revolving around it in elliptical path, and if 2A is the major axis, then the time period of revolution of the body in the surrounding of sun in elliptical path can be written as proportional to A cube. That is Kepler's law of period. We already discussed that the time period square is directly proportional to A cube. Now, in this situation, if we talk about Earth, we can write for Earth's revolution around sun, we can write the square of time period of Earth is directly proportional to Re cube. But when this body will be approaching sun in a straight line, we can assume this is an approximate elliptical path with minor axis is equal to zero. And in that case, the major axis will be Re. So this can be considered as an approximated ellipse, which is like a straight line, with major axis is equal to Re and minor axis is equal to zero. So this path we can call as a degenerated ellipse with 2A is equals to Re. So in this situation, the particle is revolving around the sun in an elliptical path with minor axis equal to zero. And in that case, obviously, the sun will be located at one of the left extreme or right extreme of the ellipse. So in this situation, we can say if T prime is the revolution period of body around sun in ellipse with minor axis is equals to zero. This can be written as T prime square, which will be proportional to Re by 2 whole cube. So if this is equation 1, this is equation 2, dividing these two equations, we can get T prime upon T whole square is equals to 1 by 8. This implies we get the value of T prime as T by 2 root 2. And the time period of Earth's revolution around sun, we know it is 365 days. So this is 365 by 2 root 2 days. This much time the body will take in revolving around the sun in this elliptical path. But we are required to find the time in which the body will be falling into the sun. That will be half of the period. So we can write time of falling of body into sun is, this can be written as T is equals to T prime by 2, which is 365 by 4 root 2 days. And if we calculate it approximately, this comes out to be 64.5 days. That will be the result of this problem.